You could call it the little fishing boat that could. A remarkable story tonight about a boat that capsized off the coast of Nantucket and then popped up a continent away years later. 11 News reporter Kai Reed was there as the Queen Bee made its first public appearance in Baltimore. Kai.
Well, Donna, the Port of Baltimore has been the Queen Bee fishing boat's resting place after a long and rather unbelievable journey.
26 feet of rust, scratches, bumps, and bruises. The kind of wear and tear that usually comes with an amazing story.
Once it left Spain, it was loaded on a freighter and shipped directly to Baltimore. And this is the first time it's been seen in the U.S.
The Queen Bee has been in Baltimore for 10 days, but its journey started in August of 2008 when Scott Douglas and his brother-in-law Rich embarked on a fishing trip that went awry.
The wave was cresting, was breaking over top of the boat. So you knew you were, at the very least, you were going to be wet. Your last thought is, you know, this is my last thought before we're going in the water.
They were thrown from the boat off the coast of Nantucket and forced to swim to shore. Scott remembers being terrified that Rich wouldn't make it.
I'm okay, but Rich isn't, you know, I don't know if he's going to live.
They both lived to see their families, but they didn't think they'd ever see their Queen Bee fishing boat again until she reappeared 3.5 years later off the coast of Spain, more than 3,000 miles away from where they last saw her. Coast Guard officials suspect that the Queen Bee's remarkable journey included drifting north towards Canada, then getting swept up in the Gulf Stream, crossing the Atlantic, and sailing down onto Spain. Spanish officials identified the boat and connected it to Scott through an identification number still visible on the back.
It really looks good.
Al Parton works with Regulator Marine, the company that constructed the boat in North Carolina.
We always knew we built a good boat, but to go through what this boat has gone through in the Atlantic for 3.5 years is just unbelievable.
Up next, Queen Bee's survival story will be shared at boat shows across the country.
We want everybody to see that. We're proud of it.
And now Regulator Marine now plans to use the boat as a learning tool. It went from Baltimore to North Carolina this evening. They're going to try and figure out exactly why it stayed intact so well and what they can learn from all of its construction. Reporting live in the studio, Kai Reed, WBAL-TV 11 News.